Yes.
Ooh, it is time to practice. Yes, let's practice together the words of Denmark's Eurovision 2021 act, Fyr og Flamme. The song is Over Ospa Hinanden, and this is a self-composed dance number, which on the face of it is about inviting your loved one to dance with you, forgetting our own internal insecurities, and just enjoying the rhythm and flow of that music. Of course, the lyrics are a little saucy. So in talking about moving your body, some people think it means practicing moving all parts of your body. But I will leave that to you to unpack. In any case, should we talk about Denmark at Eurovision 2021?
Let's do this!
Yes, Jesper and Lauritz, the two halves of Fyr og Flamme, are burning up the dance floor in this very vintage number. This could come from the 80s, and yet I've got to say, I'm loving it today in 2021. It's a bit of a guilty pleasure. Their outfits are so... they're from the depths of the Danish broadcaster's costume closet. Let's say they had to clear off all those cobwebs to pull these out. It's a little wackadoodle, very, very unhinged almost. The lead singer, his charisma, you know, he jumps off this platform, this circular platform, and he decides, I'm gonna take half of the mic stand, because why the hell not? And then he kind of spins around with it. He could have just taken the mic, y'all. He didn't need half of that metal rod, but he wanted it. He wanted that metal rod, and he is working it across the floor. Let's just listen to the lyrics, or rather read them. Time has stopped. What is it we're waiting for? Your eyes are saying the same thing as mine, so I start dancing. I've practiced it at home, and I pray to my creator that it takes hold of me. Rivals stretch their legs and wage war on a dance floor, but if you don't let go of me, then we rise. C9, are you risen?
I am opened up.
Oh, girl!
Well, he said, open your legs. No. Okay, I think they are cool. I mean, I like their, you know, energy and their personalities, characters. Mm-hmm. And I like that they sing in Danish after, I think, it's more than 20 years. You know, they sent a song to Eurovision. Wow, in Danish? That's amazing. It's like, you know, classic throwback, 80s vibe in tune of, you know, native tongue, I mean, language. I love the retro synth dance song. It's, of course, vintage, retro, as I said, but it doesn't feel like, you know, boring. I don't know why. I like to listen to it. I don't listen to it that much, but, you know, I like. The lyrics are very interesting, and, you know, people can relate to them because, you know, they say enjoy and live the moment. You know, sometimes when we are happy, like living the moment, then we start, you know, to think about the future or the past, and then we get, you know, down. Our motivation is down. Our happiness is down because we have, you know, problems and, you know, stuff to do, like when we are so busy. And I really understand that. I love the national final staging. I think it was very colorful. And, you know, it was with an orchestra that was really beautiful. And actually, it enchanted the song. I mean, the staging really does a lot for the song. Like, a lot, a lot. And, yeah, I like it. It's a, you know, decent song.
No one knows how it's done, so let's practice on each other. Soon we're two adults. You're the woman, I'm the man. The whole floor has lost its mind. Let's practice on each other. Oliver.
Where do we begin? Okay. Denmark. I love the aesthetic. I absolutely adore the looks. I think they have nailed that. I you know, this glitter blazer, the pants, the vest, it's just all so true to that, like, vaporwave almost 80s style, and I really enjoy that. But this song is an absolute car crash. I don't even think they are... It doesn't even sound like the 80s to me. It sounds like they're trying to fuse 60s music with 70s, with 80s, with a little bit of 90s thrown in there. If they'd have leaned into one genre, I think they could have done great. But this is just such an assault on the senses and not one that I can recover from. I enjoy their personality. And I do think that really comes across in the staging. And actually, since they won Dansk Melodi Grand Prix, they've gone on to show that they kind of are the personalities of this year's Eurovision season. You know, they've parodied themselves. They've done that YouTube react thing that was really funny. And they are all about enjoying themselves. This song, I just don't think quite shows that exactly. And the synths are just so stale, so cheesy. The lyrics, I can understand there's kind of a bit of a, can I say homoerotic on YouTube?
Yes, absolutely.
I'm going to say homoerotic on YouTube. There's a homoerotic vibe to these lyrics, but that doesn't quite come across with it being in Danish. I just don't think this is going to resonate with as many people. I just can't get on board with it. I find it really frustrating to listen to because I want it to be so much better than it is, and it's just messy.
Yeah, on that homoerotic line, the line in English is, "You're the woman, I'm the man," as opposed to, "You're a woman, I'm a man," suggesting the assumption of particular roles. I'm not going to unpack this. People can figure it out for themselves. In the comments section, the top comment on our lyrics post on WeeBlogs, this is from a Dane named Fred. He writes, "As a Dane, let me just clarify that it is about having sex for the first time and figuring it all out, just presented in a different package, i.e. the Eurovision disco. The innuendos are very clear in Danish." Kier replies, "Yay, hookup anthem." Mr. Vanilla Bean writes, "Giving the line, I've practiced it at home, a whole new meaning, lol." And finally, Mime actually disagrees. "As a Dane, I kindly disagree. The lyrics are about dancing." Sure, you can always interpret the lyrics to something else, but the lyrics, word for word, they're about dancing. The debate rages on. Now look, they are closing semifinal two. You know, many people call this the pimp slot right before voting. You're the last one to go. I think that this is a good closer. It's very feel good. It's very happy. Even if you don't like it, I think you can read their charisma. That lead singer, he's just doing his thing, living his best life. You know, this, he's taking that cliche phrase and he's making it true. He's doing his thing on his own terms. And I just find him actually adorable and endearing and completely creative. He's like a Danish David Bowie. Do you know what I mean? He's like on his own artistic path. I'm not saying he's going, you know, slay the charts like David Bowie, but he's got that independent spirit. That's the phrase. The independent spirit of a Freddie Mercury, of a David Bowie, of other icons. Yeah. Will this make the final? They themselves have said they're planning something cool and they hope to surprise. I don't know if that's hype, but to me that suggests that we haven't seen half of what they're going to do on that stage. We haven't seen the full fire, the full fear of Fear Ock Flamma quite yet. So it's an uphill battle. At this moment, I would say out. However, given what they've teased and given that DR in the past, well, not recently actually, DR can get it right. Sinan.
I think, you know, the semifinal has a lot of more free spots for the final as the semifinal one. You can say that. So, and they are performing last, and I think they could have a chance, but I think they will not qualify. But they are going to make, you know, I think really good show, like ending performance. I think everybody will, you know, will like to see it. You know, they, you know, when you enjoy the whole show, the last performance is actually a positive one. It doesn't matter if it's a ballad or a, you know, or a dance song. you just enjoy it, even though you don't like it. But this one, I think everybody, I can imagine, you know, press center and all, just dancing, you know, just having fun. But the people at home, I don't know what's going to happen, but they could qualify with the last position. But after Switzerland, I don't know.
Oh, that's an interesting point. It is such a big contrast with Switzerland, isn't it? Which could actually work in its favor. Switzerland mm-hmm. obviously will stand out because it's going to be epic and amazing. But this, yeah, I like contrast. Oliver, can it make it?
Despite my opinion of it, I actually think this will qualify for the final. And mm-hmm. it is that contrast that I think helps it. We do have to be very careful about the last spot in the running order. You know, famous last words of Triana Palm mm. from Latvia a few cool. years ago. You know, people thought they were going to make it because it was this massive contrast to everything else. It was last in the running order in its semi. Came dead last, I think. Came near yeah. the bottom of the scoreboard either way.
It was last, girl. And I'm still bleeding inside.
It was last. Okay.
How?
And this could very much do the same, but I actually think that more people are going to get on board with this because it's got a happiness to it and because mm. there is so much charisma to it. You know, we talk about musicality. Rating this in terms of musicality, I give it 1 out of 10, but for personality, it has to be a 10 out of 10. And I think a lot of people will get on board with that.
Well, considering both musicality and personality, it is time to go around and give our scores out of a 10 along with a justification. Let's start in Germany with Sinan.
As I said, I really enjoyed the song. I respect them a lot. I like their personalities. In Eurovision, you have to, you know, include like the whole package, not only the song, but also the singer, the performance, the, you know, all the stuff. And I gave 5.5 out of 10.
From foof, punkt, foof. We go to Oliver.
I gave this a 3. Like I said, they get so many points of personality, but just musically, it's such a mess. You know, behind the scenes tea, before we started filming this We Were Jory video, or rather this set of We Were Jory videos, I listened to the song, and then I listened to Bobby Socks, Lit It Swing. You can't tell which song is from which year. They
Girl!
Sound...
I kindly disagree.
Hey, we can disagree, that's fine.
The masculine vocal... Sorry, I'm interrupting. Please, say your piece.
That's fine. No, go ahead.
I would prefer to listen to Denmark 2021 than to Bobby Socks in 2021. Now, I love La Det Swing for its time, but in terms of for now, girl, Denmark is serving it.
I think this is the same way as Josh Dubovy, UK 2010, would have done well in 1985. Maybe Denmark 2021 would have done well in 1985. But it's just not up to date with the millennium for me. And I'm not digging it. 3 out of 10.
Millennium. I love the strings in this. Bum, bum, bum. Boo-da-boo, 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 boo-da-boo. Bum, bum, bum. Boo-da-boo, boo-da-boo. Now, listen, in terms of the studio cut, when I first heard it, I was kind of like, yeah, whatever. But it's when I saw it at DMGP, I was just so transfixed by this lead singer and his charisma and sort of freedom. And he has the X factor on stage. I don't know what it is. I could watch him all day just being silly, having fun. It just lifts my spirit. My score is a 6.5. So, you know, this is not reinventing the wheel. This is not like, I don't think this is a top 10 song, but I'm happy when it comes on and I don't skip it. Of course, I only have 2 Eurovision songs on my Spotify playlist, so this doesn't actually come on. But when it comes on a YouTube playlist, I do listen to it or watch it. In any case, yes.
Can we know which of these 2 songs you have on your Spotify?
Absolutely. It's Now, I should point out, this doesn't necessarily mean they're my favorite. Because I think what you vote for based on a stage show or a music video is completely different to what you listen to. And sometimes people don't understand this, but Lithuania Discotheque and Ireland Leslie Roy. I love these songs when I'm out and about. Like, it just keeps me going. Will I vote for them? I don't know. It depends. In any case, we are not the only Wee Wee bloggers. There are dozens of us all over the world in España, Italia, France, United States of America, Germany, you name it, Australia. And the overall global average across all these dozens of kind people is... Oh, 4.84, which, to be honest, is not a good score. Oliver, thoughts?
It's another one of the 2021 divisive entries. It just seems to be the theme this year. Open up to musical diversity, it seems. Yeah, I expected that. I'm not a fan of this, but I appreciate all of the charisma, and I think this will be a shot qualifier. Could end up doing pretty well.
Wee Wee blogger Kristen in Reykjavik will be happy. She gave this a 9.5. Wee Wee blogger Pablo in Miami in Florida, he gave this an 8.5. There is definitely love for this. It may not be consistent across the board, but it's definitely there. Sinan.
Yeah, the score is a little bit low, but I think it's the right score, probably, because of the, all the tastes we have in our team. But hey, wishing them all the best of luck, and, you know, I hope they slay the performance and, you know, end the semifinal too as it should be ended. Like with BAM performance.
Yes, serving that Alexis Mateo BAM. Well, that's what we think. What do you think? Are you a fan of Denmark? Do you think they can surprise and make the final? And if they do, how high can they climb? Let us know here on Wee Wee Blogs.
Please write all of your opinions as a comment down this video, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel because we have so many things coming up. Oh my gosh, so excited.
And be sure to follow us on socials. We're on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, whatever it may be. Give us a follow at Wee Wee Blogs.
And we will see you later. Bye.
Bye.